Time is going by so much faster than I'm starting to regret not spending all of it with you. Now I'm wondering why I've kept this bottle inside. So I'm starting to regret not selling all of it to you. So if I haven't yet, I've got to let you know you're never gonna be alone. From this moment
we met one night at the Fiddler. I was just dancing away having fun, and then across the dance floor I looked and there was this girl, and she'd done this dance move, which was my dance move, the body pump.
I was doing the pump, as we call it, and then George came up to me and started pumping back.
I've run up to her and just looked and done the body pump and then run off again, and that was it.
It was funny, and then he ran off and I was like, who's that guy?
The next thing I know, she came over and we just started dancing.
Then later in the night I wanted more attention from this guy, and then we were just dancing and having fun. And
she said, by the way, my name is Heather. And I thought, well, yeah, now I'm being disrespectful. I haven't asked her name. I'm dancing with this girl. So I said, look, I apologize. I'm sorry. That's so rude of me. I should have actually asked your name. Let me buy you a drink. I remember she got blisters on her heels, and she was having problems dancing. So I went and seen some of the staff that were working there and asked for some band-aids. And so here we are, me and a couple of the security guys, the bouncers, we're all there sort of taking her heels off and putting band-aids on her feet and making sure she was all right and she could walk and all that.
Before he drove me home, we went out to the, what's it called, the Fiddler Burger Shack, where you buy Fiddler Burgers. And he supermanned me. So he picked me up like this and
started walking down, and she goes, oh, my feet are sore, I can't walk anymore. I said, yeah, lay down across my arms. She goes, really? And I took her heels, her high heels off, and I put them in the side of my pockets in my cargo pants, and she laid down across my arms and carried her all the way back down to my car. That was the night we met. I had to ask her three times before I got the yes, put it that way. So I actually went down on my knee and it was right across there.
We went to Crack Pepper Restaurant and just having a lovely meal, and George ducked out for a cigarette and came back in and sitting at the wall, and
there was an ant climbing on the wall, and that was my point of distraction where I said, oh, Heather, look, there's an ant on the wall. And she's turned and looked at the wall. And I've dropped down on one knee, and as she's turned back and looked at me, I've held this box.
And then I looked over, and he wasn't in his chair, he was sitting next to me, and he was on his knee, and I was like, what are you doing? Or I can't recall specifically, but it was, what are you doing? And then he opened, he had this big box in his hand, and it was bigger than a ring box. I've never been this close to anyone or anything. I can hear your thoughts, I can see your dreams. I don't know how you do what you do. I'm so in love with you. It just keeps getting better. I wanna spend the rest of my life with you by my side, forever and ever. he started saying, "Heather Penelope Tong, will you do me the honour of being my wife and making me a father again?"
And she's going, no, it's in the box, it's in the box. I said, "Heather, yes or no, will you do me the honour of making me a father again?" And then she's like, "Oh," and opened it up and then, yeah.
And I said yes, obviously.
With tears. And a lot of relief for me, because that was one of my most nerve-wracking moments.
Mrs. George and Heather Pack.
Mr. and Mrs. George and Heather Pack. Every little thing that you do.
Every little thing that you do. Baby, I'm amazed by you.
Maybe. Intuition, but some things you just don't question. Like in your eyes, I see my future in an instant. And there it goes, I think of my best
Alright, George and Heather, wishing you the very best. It's about time. Enjoy the most of it.
Georgie, Heather, congratulations again and all the best in your future endeavours.
Heather, George, just wanted to wish you all the best.
I wish you all the best, so here's to love, laughter and happily ever after.
Thank you. Cheers, boys. I just want to say congratulations. You are a lovely couple. We love you both to death and we want you to have a long and happy life together, and I can't wait to be grandmother.
Congratulations, Heather and George.